In this video, we will learn about the key features of Adrenaline Bot and most popular plugins for it. If you haven't installed the bot yet, watch our video related to this topic. You will find a link to it in the tips and in the end of this video. So, first of all, what is the Adrenaline Bot? This is a program that allows you to automate in-game actions in the game Lineage 2. With the help of the Adrenaline Bot, you can control a whole full party at once, or even more number of characters. Behavior is configured through the interface and scripts. The interface is a familiar window for many with various settings, where you can set up attacking skills, buff, healing, and so on. Scripts are arbitrary algorithms written in the Delphi programming language that allow you to control the character as you want. Let's first examine the main Adrenaline Bot window. By default, the Russian interface language is selected in the bot. To switch the language to English, click in the menu. Language, English. Keep in mind that not all license types have access to English, so read the descriptions carefully. On the left we see a list of accounts. This is a list of running windows that are controlled by the bot. Accounts are automatically added to this list when the game clients are launched. If you want to disable the detection of game windows, so-called injection, then click Menu, Disable. To turn the injection back on, activate this function either there in the menu or click on the icon with the image of a green Android. Essentially, the list of accounts is a fundamental control element. If we select any account, all other interface elements will start displaying information associated with this particular account. For example, information about the HP, MP of our character and his target. Below we see the messages list. There are several tabs here. By default, a tab where the logs of running scripts are displayed is open. But we can also see here in-game chats and even some information about our target. Stats, equipment and buffs. Let's move on to the map. It is needed so that we can understand where the character is, even if the game window is minimized, and see his environment. Monsters, players, drop. If you see a blue screen instead of a map, make sure that you downloaded the maps by the updater and turned on displaying of the map and the bot. You can also use it to draw combat zones where your bot will farm. To draw a zone, you need to right-click on it and activate the Edit Zone function. Then draw the zone and save it by giving it some name. Not so long ago, we added the ability to open separate windows with maps for each character. This is convenient if you need several characters to be visible at once. By the way, using these windows, you can quickly pause the bot on certain characters. In addition, the bot displays various information about the world around it. A list of players around us, their nicknames, classes, clan names and distance to them. List of party members, divided into players and their pets, summons. Basic information about the character. His pets, skills, buffs and inventory. Drop and NPC lists. It also displays statistics on farming. How long the bot is online, how much it has earned, and so on. Such statistics can be useful when you want to understand which spot is more profitable to farm. Next to the map is the script editor. Here we can edit and run scripts and plugins. We'll talk about scripts in the editor in detail a little later. Displaying of the listed interface elements can be turned off and on by selecting View, Panels in the top menu, and configuring what to display and what not. You can also customize the location of all elements of the bot's main window. For this, you need to grab some element by the title and drag it wherever you want. If suddenly during such an attempt everything got out of control and you want to return everything to its original state, turn off the bot via menu, exit. Just clicking on the cross does not turn off the bot, and delete the settings.ini file located in the settings folder. Now let's move on to an overview of the bot interface for configuring the behavior of characters in battle. To open the interface, you need to select an account and click on the button with the gear image. An interface window will appear. The navigation menu is located on the left. Below it is a drop-down list for selecting the bot config and enabling, disabling the bot functions. The config of the bot stores information about how it needs to behave in battle, what skills use to attack, what buffs to use, what mobs to kill, and so on. Each config has its own name. The config can be created both for a specific character and, for example, named by his name, and for a group of characters of the same type. For example, you have 10 spoilers, they farm in different locations, but everyone can use the same typical config. Below are the buttons that turn on and off both certain functions of the bot and the entire bot as a whole. Auto attack is responsible for the behavior associated with the search for new targets, including the assist, their attack, and the picking up of a drop. Heal is responsible for the heal functions configured in the self-heal and party heal buff tabs. Buffs is responsible for the rebuff functions configured in the self-buff and party heal buff tabs. Events activates tracking of events and reaction to them. Note that event tracking occurs even when the bot is paused. We will not go into detail about all the settings pages in this video. You can find detailed instructions for all settings on our channel in a separate playlist. But let's briefly articulate why all these tabs are needed. Self-heal. Here the list of skills and items for healing is configured. The logic related to the regen, when we just sit down and wait, and our actions in case of the death of the character, are also configured here. Self-buff. In this tab, you can set up a list of skills, items, or the choice of dialogues in Alt plus B for a rebuff during a battle, with different conditions for each item. Party heal buff. Also a custom list, but now the settings are related to party members. Party settings. Here the interaction of bots with other characters is configured. Making a party, accepting invitations and other dialogues. Assist, following, protecting party members and so on. Attack. In this tab, you can configure the list of skills that bot will use to attack opponents. For each skill, you can customize its conditions. Target search. Here you can configure both the general behavior associated with the search for new targets and the filters of mobs with priorities. Combat zone. Here we indicate exactly where the bot should look for new targets. As a rule, the drawn map, which was mentioned earlier, is indicated here. Drop. Here you can configure the general parameters for the drop picking up, as well as filters. Miscellaneous. In this tab you can set up fishing, crafting, auto-unpacking of soul shot packs, modify the standard base of monsters, items, bot skills, as well as additional settings. Events. Here you can configure a list of events that the bot will track and react to these events. Let's return now to the script editor. With it, you can write, compile, and run your own scripts as well as those written by other people. Thanks to scripts, Adrenaline Bot can automate almost any action in the game. There are three different types of scripts. Open source. These are plain text files that can be opened with any text editor. Have the .txt or .pass extension. When you run such script, it is first compiled each time, and only then launched. Encrypted. The bot has the possibility to encrypt a script, after that its source code cannot be viewed. With encryption, you can also bind the script to a specific PC. Such scripts have the .env extension, and they are very useful if, for example, you share a script with your friend, but do not want to show the source code. When you run such a script, it is also first compiled, and only then launched. Binary. These are already compiled scripts, i.e. they start immediately. They have the .bin extension. Such scripts have a number of advantages. They do not load the processor at the compilation stage, their source code is reliably protected, and if your script has many modules, then at the output they will all be collected into one file. But there is also one drawback: if the script engine is updated in the bot, such scripts will stop working, they will need to be recompiled. All scripts launch the same way. First you need to select the account on which you want to run the script. Then in the script editor click on the icon with the folder image. And in the dialog box that opens, select the script you want to run. Then press the start button. On our site there are many ready-made scripts for all occasions. Hunter, for killing mobs, returning to spot, rebuffing, buying consumables and selling drop. Expert, for quest leveling of any characters on different chronicles. Next target, a radar with a huge number of PvP features. Boost, for enchanting items and skills, inserting life stones, synthesis, and so on. Boxer, for auto login and control of running windows, etc. You can get acquainted with the complete list of scripts by the link in the description. Also, the Adrenaline bot implements pathfinding algorithms so that bots can move in the game along pre-drawn routes in just a couple of lines of code. There is a special script for editing Root's GPS editor, and it is also presented on our website. You will find details on how to use it on the page with its description. Now you have a general idea of what the Adrenaline bot is capable of. You can buy it on our official website, adrenalinebot.com. If you have any questions, you can contact our tech support on Discord. We also recommend that you familiarize yourself with other videos on our channel related to setting up an Adrenaline bot.